Okay, up here on the roof of another Carl's Jr. That's what we do. This is the kitchen AC. They say it's not working. And also, this is the dine AC. They say whenever it runs, there's water that drains through the ceiling. And you can see there's water. Spongy roof. Yes. And I'm guessing that's going to be the culprit. We got the AC drains into that. Let's see. Pretty sure that's working. It's either something in here is leaking into the ceiling and runs down to this side, and they think this is where the leak is at because it runs through the rafters, or there could be something over here. They've had a leak for a very long time, but I guess I'm gonna have to go in there. Looks like some leaves. More than clogged up. It's bubbling. I don't really have anything to clear it out. Yeah. That's not disgusting. Tell you what, I'm gonna grab the hose and shove it down there. It's not gonna sit there. Grab a hose, dodge the bees. There's plenty of wasps on this roof. Nope, looks like the hose is on that side. I like to live in there. Oh, I see one. Yeah, they like it in there. How far down we can shove the hose. Well, that's how far it goes. And it looks like it's cleared. The hose to save the day. I think that's going to be one issue solved. Other issue. Kitchen AC is down. maybe a little bit of maintenance would help. Clean some coils. It's pretty common the person that is supposed to be doing the maintenance does not do the maintenance. Which is good for me, I guess. See when's the last time they were out here. June 20th. Came out, changed some filters, and yeah. Like 40 days ago. Month and 10 days-ish. Maybe a month and a half now. Coils don't get that dirty after a month and a half. And the lights are flashing. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep, 4 and 5. Pretty sure those are high pressures. There's 4 HPS2 compressor lockout. 5. Oh. Low pressure compressor lockout on stage 1. Interesting. Test reset. Test reset. Best we can for cleaning right now. Just clean them off on the outside. Doop, doop, doop. My bag's getting wet. Move that somewhere else. Yes, there's more of a proper way to do this. Try to get it where it's breathing right now. Look how dirty that is. Yes, they pay someone to do this. And then that company doesn't do it. And then they pay me to do it. It's a win for me, I guess. At least 50 to 75% better. It's not a double coil, so water actually goes through there pretty easily. Pushes a lot of the dirt through. I always wonder why it breaks. Why do they always break in summer? I don't know. Maybe because your maintenance people aren't doing maintenance stuff? Why do we have leaks in the ceiling? Well, I don't know. Not doing a proper roof maintenance. Stage 2 came on. It got pretty hot. 107, I think, the last couple of days. Still got 5. Oh, there's stage 1. Stage 1 isn't coming on. Yep. Yeah, Yep, okay.
So I'm pushing on the depressor here. And...
got nothing. So there's no refrigerant in stage one. Zero. Not seeing any oil. Driver, open it up. Frickin' wasps are going around, they're gonna kill me. Stage one coil is on the outside, the underneath one is number two. I'll see. There's only one way to find this out. Nitrogen gauges and the leak detector. I'm gonna get on it. Alright, back on the roof. With all my stuff, water, nitrogen, leak detector, that in the shade, some soap bubbles, always, and my gauges. I will figure out where the heck this leak is. Bit of oil in those. Probably not where it's leaking at. Who are we working with? We're working with 410A. Like that really matters at the moment. So we're gonna fill it with nitrogen. A little rubber. We're gonna fill it with nitrogen and just check for a leak. So it really doesn't matter what the refrigerant setting is. I wonder why they put these on the opposite side. There we go. High side is hooked up. Still at zero. For some reason, I see they use the blue leak. Or is that the leak? Forget what that is. Thread sealant. Blue thread sealant on there, which is never good. There's some more. Maybe that's where the leak is. Why else would they do that? Seems weird. Alright. Hook up my nitrogen. 200. First thing I'm gonna do is turn off the unit. So we don't need compressor number one turning on full of nitrogen. Let that fill up. But it's kind of slow to jump over to that high side.
Cool.
Turn on the leak detector. It seems slow. I'll turn that on too. Fill it up extra fast. Open that. Hopefully that was just a flaw. Oh no, it's not. Not even sure I need the leak detector. I can hear it. Oh yeah. Oh, it's right there. Beep! I'm sure you guys can hear that one. This one needs a brand new coil. Hey. I didn't need all this stuff. Okay, so before I turn it back on, release all the nitrogen because we don't want it coming on with nitrogen in it. Ruin the compressor. Oh man. Just thinking about it. I'm gonna have to get a crane to put it up on the roof because it won't come up through the hatch. And the roof has like 10 to 15 feet before the edge of it once you get over the wall. And it's all tile. It can be done, but I guess that's all for this one. We cleared the leak. The water leak and found the refrigerant leak. Cleaned the coil so stage two will work. All right, back to zero PSI G. Crank this back on so they get the little bit of air conditioning they have. Give York a call and we'll figure out how much it's gonna cost, where the coil's at, how long it's gonna take to get here, work up a quote, send it to them, get the okay. I'm turning this off. Bye.